both of them in very fine form yesterday in the semi-finals. We were fortunate enough to have both of those semi-finals on this court, dispatching very experienced players in both seeds. Michelle Lee, the number two seed and favorite here, was beaten in straight games 21-18, 21-12 by Kawakami. And Ayumi Mini took out the Bulgarian Linda Zecchiri, the number seven seed, again in straight games 22-20, 21-12. So players and officials just meeting for the coin toss. Ayumi Mini wins the coin toss and elects to serve. And I think she's going to stay at the end nearest the camera. So Ayumi Mini, she's ranked 88 in the world, but I'd say it's true of both of these players. Their rankings don't really reflect the ability. There's so much talent coming out of Japan these days. She's 24 years old. She's about 5 years older than her opponent, but these two very equal, very evenly matched, and I'm sure as teammates they'll know each other's games very well, so we could be in for a thrilling final here in the women's singles. There you see that semi-final I mentioned earlier against Linda Zecchiri. It's been a tough week for Mini, taking out the number three seed from Japan. Her teammate Hashimoto was quite a surprise for everybody here, really. 21-15, 21-14 in the quarterfinal. A fairly comfortable second round match against Vietnam, but her toughest game looks like round one, where Gaida of India took Mini to three. Mini just coming through that one, 21-18. Kawakami, the 19-year-old. Well, 18-year-old, I think she's 19 soon. A similar ranking again at 86, but some of the matches she's played recently and some of the people she's beaten just goes to show that I don't think her ranking really reflects her performance. She had a tough quarterfinal against Delphine Lansak, a really thrilling match to watch. Lansak around the same age as Kawakami, another young gun from France. That match was over an hour long, finishing 21-12, but a much more comfortable semi-final yesterday against the favorite here, Michelle Lee, the number two seed. Michelle Lee did not have her best day, really. But it was Kawakami's defense that really made the difference yesterday. The shuttle just kept coming back and Michelle Lee ran out of ideas.
Ladies and gentlemen,
our Austrian service judge there, Jeanek. Don't think we'll have quite as many issues with serves in singles matches as we do with the doubles.
I only need to serve. Love all.
Especially both of these two players. Oh, that's nice to see, showing so much respect to all of the officials, and it gets a round of applause from the crowd too. What a way to start the match, an opening rally. Great defense at the start from Mini, but those last two shots from Kawakami just played to perfection. Mini, not the tallest of athletes, and So she did leave a few gaps on the court. Yes, great net play from Kawakami as well.
Two, long.
That's unfortunate, the overhead slice from Kawakami just clipping the tape, but the intention was good. At only 19 years old, I don't think it will be very long before we see Kawakami climb the rankings to the top 30 in the world, I would say. And let's see if my prediction's right, but it's Kawakami in orange that I predict will take this women's singles final. Oh. Great skill to turn the shuttle across court, but I think there was some slight miss hit off the frame. The intention was there. She meant the shuttle to be placed cross court, but perhaps not quite in that style. Well, that's a shame. Another great rally from these two. The overhead from Kawakami just letting her down slightly the last 2 points.
That's over. 4-3.
Couple errors from both players in the last two rallies, deciding the points. Early stages, of course, they're just feeling their way into this match. Well, that one was a long way wide.
5-4.
Kawakami just feeling the pressure slightly, perhaps. Defense from Ayumi Mini. The dive to the forehand side and the control she had to keep that in play.
4.
Absolutely amazing stuff. I don't know how she managed to get that over the net, but Kawakami had the whole court to aim at. All she had to do was get it back in play, but she made the error herself. Great defense this time from Kawakami. Oh, it's gone over. Incredible touch from Ayumi Mini. And the desperate dive by Kawakami, just sat on top of the tape and fell over. The apology to her teammate, just a sign of respect, really, because, well, Ayumi Mini really did play well in that point, didn't deserve to lose it.
Set over, 7-7, all.
Yeah, the cross-court slice this time working for Kawakami. That was much better.
That's over. 8-7.
Yeah, well judged from Kawakami. That was always drifting wide, but signs of the potential that both of these players have. Some of these shots and their court coverage is just incredible. How they are able to lunge out on that leg and the control and balance they've got to get back. That's the difference that some of these Japanese players, both of them bowing as they walk off at the mid-game interval. It's Kawakami with the lead at 11-7. Some awesome attacking, but some awesome defending too from both of these at the moment. 4 points the gap, but it probably doesn't do justice to the game we've seen. There isn't much between these two yet.
11-7.
Kawakami hitting a few winners, but also making a few errors. That's so nice to see. She just bowed to her opponent. I know they're teammates, but it's such a nice sign of respect between these two players. Oh, that was amazing. The reverse straight slice on the overhead from Kawakami. The technical ability it takes to play that with such control is so impressive. Again, just showing what I was talking about at the break. Oh, nearly again, Ayumi Mini. She's not the tallest of athletes, but how she is able to stretch that far, reach the shuttle, and then get back in court so quickly.
13,
that's the kind
7.
Of thing that you just don't see amongst European players, for instance, or at least not many of them. Certainly those that are ranked 90-ish in the world, like these two are. That's why, for me, it won't be long before both of these players climb right up the rankings. Their retrieval skills are just incredible.
Six.
Yeah, that forehand slice from Ayumi Mini just drifting long as she turns to have a quick word with her coach. Great smash from Kawakami. Mini this time managed to just get a racket on it, but it clipped the edge and 16, drifted seven. Wide. And the error at the net this time. This game just running away with Ayumi Mini at the moment. 17-7. What a rally. This has everything. Oh, what a shame to finish up such a way. The unforced error from Mini again.
18-7.
An 11-point lead now. It's come from nowhere suddenly. Kawakami just running away with his first game. The serve was a bit short. Mini's attack was good, but it was the speed at which she got to the net that made the difference. That was very close indeed.
18.
I think we may have seen a challenge there from Super Series events if that system was in place. Not today, of course. And a couple of errors, both players.
10. 18.
The 8-point lead probably enough to see Kawakami take this opening game. Umpire just correcting himself, 11-18 with Ayumi Mini serving. Yeah, good attacking from Ayumi. Reach, she can get to the shuttle from that defensive position. It's incredible, this pocket rocket, Ayumi Mini. How she covers the court so quickly at only 1.50 meters something. It's quite incredible. Oh, the crowd loving this. What a rally from Ayumi Mini. Great defense again from Mini, but not quite good enough. Kawakami very early to pounce at the net. 13. Great stuff from Ayumi Mini to start clawing her way back into this match. I'd say it's a little too late for this game at the moment, but good to see a fight back nonetheless. Oh, the deception at the net from Mini and a great recovery from Kawakami, but it was Mini again that stepped in early and pushed the shuttle just through the defense of her opponent. This is just wonderful stuff. That's great play, Ayumi Mini again. Some really amazing rallies in this women's singles final. I was talking last night with one of the players about how Japan seems to have 15, 20 players perhaps in the world top 50 at the moment. And these two here are more like 86 and 88 in the world. It's amazing how much strength in depth Japan has in, well, not just women's singles, but doubles as well at the moment. So much discipline has gone into the last 4 or 5 years in Japan. And if they can keep producing players of this standard, it really will be the world dominant force before too long. Game point here for Kawakami. Okay. And it only takes one. The forehand cross slice was played to perfection. And she takes the opening game in this women's singles final at the US Open, 21-16. So some advice from coaching staff for both players from Japan here. Kawakami has such a lead. It was quite incredible play from Ayumi Mini, really, to get her way back into the game slightly towards the end of that first opening game, but it was slightly too late. And if it wasn't for some of the errors from Kawakami at the start, would have been a much more much bigger gap in the scoreline, but signs that Ayumi Mini is never ready to give up at this stage, so let's see if she can turn this around and take us to three. Again, the crowd clapping as Kawakami bows to every one of the line judges. Well, much like the first game, a fantastic opening rally. And much like the first game, the first point goes to Kawakami. The reverse slice from Ayumi Mini. The balance of shuttle placement over deception is always a great interest in the technical side of badminton. That, oh, bit of luck with the net cord from Kawakami. Yes, Ayumi Mini's previous winner was almost a meter inside the sideline, so the position wasn't great, but it was the disguise she put on the shot that confused her opponent for a moment. Good pressure from Kawakami. From the return of serve onwards, she was just maintaining the attack. Drive into her opponent's body, too much for a Ayumi Mini to handle. Yeah, well left from Mini. Great defense from Mini again. Oh. And again, she gets herself back into the rally and then plays the unforced error. She seems to play better when she has no time at all to think. Great pressure from Kawakami. Taking a deep breath to compose herself as well. It's 5-5 here in the second. And it is a shame after watching rallies like this to see them end in an unforced error, but very hard to maintain this sort of level. Again from Kawakami. Meany this time with the 3-point lead. Oh, that was fantastic from Ayumi Meany. The net shot was perfect and she just held her ground so well, expecting the net reply. She was on that so early. Now come on, Kawakami, she's making too many errors here. Another great rally. It's great defense from both women. And it's Ayumi Meany with a 6-point lead as she takes the first half of this second game and goes into the break at 11-5. Players just asking for a few bits of moisture to be mopped up from the court. In readiness now to resume this game at 11-5 with Ayumi Meany with the serve. Yeah, that shot's let Kawakami down a few times today. That cross-court drop has just caught the tape on a number of occasions, especially in this second game. Well played, Mini. The net tape knockoff didn't have enough on it, and she allowed her opponent to get behind it, get back into the rally, but in the end, it was Kawakami with another error at the net. And again, the drop shot just not working for Kawakami at the moment. Ayumi Mini with a 9-point lead, how the momentum can shift in a match. That was much better from Kawakami. That straight smash play to perfection. Nothing Mini could have done about it.
And 6-14.
She reclaims the serve, but at 8 points down. It might be Kawakami this time that has too much of a lead to chase. Just having a word with Kawakami for trying to dry her face and flick the sweat off court. Unbelievable rule in badminton, how players are not allowed to towel down.
16-6.
Great straight smash from Kawakami, and again, it's nice to see the respect between these two.
7-16.
Going to retrieve the shuttle herself. It's quite unusual in top-level singles to see that amongst opponents. Kawakami letting Mini run away with this second game.
17-7.
She's made 7 or 8 errors. That's largely the difference between the score. Skill from Kawakami. And again. Oh, brilliant from Kawakami. She really showed us everything in that particular point, from net deception, power, placement, the touch of the net. With Ayumi Mini's defense, and if Kawakami can keep up that level of badminton, it could be in for a really exciting finish to this match. well left, Kawakami. I mean, he hasn't made many mistakes so far this game, and she was really trying to find the deep corner. So close to perfection, and yet a few millimeters, and it's the error that gives her opponent a 8-point lead now in this second game in the women's singles final. Yeah, very nice from Yumi Mini. That reverse slice on occasion working so well for her. Game point. Ayumi Mini to take the second game and take us to a third and final deciding game in this women's singles final. Mini deciding not to fight for that one, but I'm sure she will from here. She doesn't need to, it drifts wide. There's the second game. The error from Kawakami, and it's Ayumi Mini second who takes the second, 21-11. So it's one game all in the women's singles final here at the US Open. Ayumi Mini taking that second, 21-11, and it was a great fight back. But too many errors from Kawakami in that second game.
Thank you. Yeah, well judged from Kawakami.
That one drifting just an inch or so long. Great hold from Kawakami, that net drive. The technique was amazing. Oh, it's brilliant. When she keeps her attack in court, there's very little anyone can do about it. It's almost perfect badminton, but so many times we saw in the second, she wasn't able to do that, and the errors crept in. But she's almost unplayable when she keeps it in court. Oh, that was great from Mini. Her technique to hold her opponent guessing, keep her opponent guessing at the net and play that hold. And the drive.
First over, 1-3.
Great technique from both of these two. Incredible length from the lift, the net shot was perfect. Oh. Such a shame that these rallies don't deserve to end with an unforced error. Judge from Mini, that was only a couple of centimeters long. Just warning the player not to give any kind of signals to the line judges. This player's warned not to try and assert any influence over them whatsoever, which is only fair. Great punch clear this time from Kawakami. Just mixing up her attack to keep Ayumi Mini guessing. Played very well. Oh, it was brilliant. Mini this time doing exactly the same thing. She had enough time to do anything she wanted with that shuttle, and on this occasion the cross-court drive. Yesterday we saw something similar against Linda's Cheery, but on that occasion she chose to go long with the punch over the head. Oh, well left again. Great attacking play from Ayumi Mini. Such resolve, such determination and commitment to never letting the shuttle die. Keep fighting, it's testament to her abilities in defense, just like that, never giving up. A really good example to any young players out there watching, just the athleticism it takes to try and keep the rally alive. So many times in this final we've seen points that look like they're going the way of Kawakami, but Mini somehow manages to do something to keep it going. And it's certainly working for her. She's 8-5 up now in this singles final. Really nothing in it at the moment in this third and deciding game in the women's singles. These two teammates, they look like close friends. We're not entirely sure, but the sign of respect they've been showing each other throughout the match suggests they're very friendly. And they probably know each other's game very well. With the net court knockoff, and oh, the disguise on that forehand again, that cross court drive. The recovery, both of these players, so impressive. Oh, and Kawakami with the error at the net. It isn't often we hear a crowd applaud a point that ends in an error like that, but it's the rest of the rally they're applauding, because some of the defensive work from both of these two is, well, it's really top level stuff. So this game going down to the wire, it seems, at 9-8. It's early to call, but with these two knowing each other so well, it had three games written all over it, really. Yeah, well left. Ayumi Mini just watching that one drift wide. Eight. great attack from Ayumi Mini. She just maintained the pressure and kept pushing her opponent. She takes the lead at 11-8 in this third and final game in the women's singles final. We are changing ends here. That punch clear from Kawakami, and the forehand cross-court drive from Ayumi Mini in reply. Nothing much between them in this final. It's a really tough one to call. There's Lee Hyun Il just finishing his warm-up on the practice court. He's up next in the men's singles. Next match on court, we've got Lee Hyun Il of Korea against Kanta Suniyama of Japan, the new young star. But back to the action. It's an all-Japanese women's singles final here, which has gone to a third and final deciding game.
12-8.
Ayumi Mini with the four-point lead at 12-8. The dive was fantastic. I mean, he wasn't in position to recover and get back. All Kawakami had to do was keep it in court. This time she did. We've seen it a few times the last couple of days where they've had an open court to aim at and missed. Kawakami this time at least keeping it in play.
Save solver, line. 2-1.
Cross slice. Oh, it's brilliant from Mini. Everything about that rally was perfect, and she maintained her composure and attack. Forced a weak net shot, and she was in so early to kill. 13-9. My prediction's going wrong here. I expected Kawakami to be asserting herself on this final, but it's Ayumi Mini with the lead now. Brilliant stuff. That drive played to perfection, deep into the corner. Ayumi Mini has built up just 14, enough
9.
Of a lead to feel slightly more comfortable. I think we'll see her really going for some shots in the next couple points, just to see if she can break the spirit of Saena Kawakami. As I say that, perhaps too complacent, her high serve drifts long. And it's back to basics, probably. Well, the body smash this time, Kawakami couldn't get a racket on it. Goes straight through her, 15-10. that net hold again. The soft hands of Ayumi Mini, and that kill played perfectly. Same spot, deep into the corner once again.
16-10.
The battle cry from Ayumi Mini every time she goes to serve. Something of a nervous tick, perhaps. That it matters, it's the play that counts, and her defense there was incredible. How she picked up that smash, she's lying on the floor.
17-10.
Signs of Lin Dan, Lee Chong Wei, those kind of players that are able to get from that position back in play, play such control at the net, get the weak lift, and that kill gives her a 7-point advantage now. Yes, it was the shuttle that clipped the net on the way through to the floor. Oh, Idris Long. Well, that was a crucial point, I'd say. 18-11 now, it's very unlikely Kawakami is going to find a way back into this game. Ayumi Mini is just playing too well. She's not making many errors. And she's in full control of this final now.
That's all for 12-18.
Well, Ayumi Mini just showing us the range of shots she's got, because so often has she been holding that and playing soft net. This time instead, she just drives down the backhand of Kawakami. Just 2 points now to the end of this match. Great cross net though from Kawakami. Let's just see if the younger of these two Japanese girls has got anything left in the tank to claw her way back. 6 points behind, though, it's tough from here. Yeah, bad decision from Mini this time. Kawakami was on the net just waiting.
14-19.
Pretty good experience there. Seems to me Ayumi Mini, after losing those 2 points in a row from this position, was just looking for some extra time to compose herself. Again with a full range of shots. What a wonderful rally, just showing us what she's capable of. Frustration on the face of Kawakami. Match point in the US Open Women's Singles Final 2016. Ayumi Kawakami under real pressure now at this point, 14-20. great shots from Kawakami, but Ayumi Mini's defense has been unbreakable at times today, and there again. Oh, what a wonderful rally. How many times was Ayumi Mini on the floor in that rally? She kept it going. But Kawakami clinging on to this match by the skin of her teeth. What a save of match point. So let's see how many more times Saena Kawakami can do that and stay in this match from 15-20 down in the third. Oh, but the net shot again drifts wide. Ayumi Mini really deserved that final. There was a few errors from Kawakami, but the defense of Ayumi Mini was just unbreakable. And the crowd in full appreciation of our US Open Women's Singles Champion, the 24-year-old from Japan, Ayumi Mini, taking that match 16-21, 21-11, 21-15.
Thank you.
So we just saw Ayumi Mini picking up the prize money and the trophy here at the Yonex US Open 2016. What a great women's singles final that was. It really had everything, the power, the speed, the accuracy of these players, but in the end it was the defensive abilities of Ayumi Mini. Couple of rallies she was on the floor more than once towards the end of the match. I think there was one time she was on the floor four or five times, and that never say die attitude was enough to break the spirit of her opponent Kawakami, who in the end ran out of ideas and made some errors. Picking up the check there for $9,000. So we've witnessed two great finals so far. We've got the men's singles up next on court one. It's Lee Hyun Il, the, I wouldn't say veteran, but he's certainly at the end of his career. Former top 10 player in the world. He's up against another young star from Japan, Kanta Sunoyama. Semi-final yesterday for Lee Hyun Il was fairly comfortable, overcoming Kevin Corden of Guatemala, 21-16, 21-8. And the surprise for me was how Kanta Sunoyama managed to keep such a composed and controlled game together, beating AJ Jayaram of India, the number four seed, 21-10, 21-14. So the officials and line judges are ready and waiting on court one as we see Lee Hyun Il and Kanta Sunoyama make their way to the court. The older Lee Hyun Il, the more experienced man, possibly